Hi everyone, so today in the kitchen here on Le Gourmet TV, we're going to make a cauliflower soup. So we're gonna start out with some leeks. Now I've already cleaned the leeks. They are a bit of a pain to clean. It's already been done ahead of time, and we're just gonna do a rough chop. You don't have to cut these down too much because this is gonna be a pureed creamed soup. And just take these, toss them into the pot. Now I've got one potato, and I'm just gonna cut that in half, and then I'm gonna slice this fairly thinly so that it cooks as quickly as the leeks and the cauliflower. Those will cook really quickly. Potato takes a little bit longer. So we'll just slice that a little more thinly. And just gather these up and into the pot. Now I'm gonna use a whole head of cauliflower. Now I've already rinsed this through, so it's clean, and we just you just have to roughly cut it. Again, it's going to be pureed, so at this point it's just about cutting it down into manageable pieces to get into the pot and pieces that will cook quickly. A little bit of salt and pepper. And I'm using my own chicken stock, so it's not too salty. If you're using a commercial chicken stock, do watch the amount of salt that you put in. And I've got about a liter of chicken stock, a quart for our American friends. And that's it. I'm just gonna put this on the stove, kind of a medium temperature, bring it up to a boil, and then take it down to a low simmer. Of course, it's going to be covered. And come back and check on it occasionally, and at about 20 minutes you should start to see it to be cooked through. So about 20 minutes have passed, and this is cooked down to the point where the cauliflower has pretty much lost all of its shape, the leeks are falling apart, and the potatoes are really mushy. So now we're going to put this into a blender. And if you had an immersion blender, that would work really well here as well. But I don't, so I'm going to use this countertop model. So now because this is still really hot, I'm going to leave the small little cap out of the center of the blender, and I'm going to cover it with a tea towel. Start it off with stir, just to get it going, and then puree. That's it, really doesn't take too long. And what you do is you just pour this into a clean pot. So the next step is to now take our puree, a cup of heavy cream, and you mix this in to the soup. We put this back on the stove and we simmer it for another 5 or 10 minutes. So the second simmer is done, and this really is your opportunity to give it a taste. Adjust your salt and pepper levels to something that suits you, and also you can change the consistency of the soup by adding milk. And I can't really tell you how much milk to add. You might not need to add any if you like it really thick. If you like it a little thinner, you can add milk to it until it comes to your favorite consistency. And then you just scoop it out and we get it ready to serve. So I'm gonna put this into a tureen and allow my dinner guests to serve themselves as they like. Hope you enjoy this one. It's a really hearty soup for a cool winter or late fall day. Thanks a lot, and I hope to see you again soon.